Welcome to the video tutorial lessons on econometrics. In today's lesson, we are going to learn about the method of ordinary least squares. The method of ordinary least squares is credited to a German mathematician called Carl Friedrich Gauss. This method is one of the powerful and popular methods of regression analysis. Let us recall the population regression function, which is of the form yi equals beta 1 plus beta 2 xi plus ui. It is noted that the population regression function is not directly observable, so we work with a sample and estimate it from the sample regression function. The sample regression function is therefore given by yi equals beta 1 hat plus beta 2 hat xi plus ui hat, where beta 1 hat plus beta 2 hat xi is the estimated or conditional mean of y, noted as yi hat. Thus, substituting the estimated y into the sample regression function, it is reduced further to the form yi equals yi hat plus ui hat. The residual or error term ui is simply the difference between yi and yi hat. This is also the same as making the error term ui the subject. Substituting the estimated y into the equation, the error term ui equals yi minus beta 1 hat minus beta 2 hat xi. In such a case, we might want to determine the sample regression function in such a manner that it is as close as possible to the actual y. So we adopt the criterion that the sum of residuals is as small as possible. Thus, applying the summation notation to both sides of the equation, we have sigma ui equals sigma yi minus yi hat. In order to simplify this notation, we want to remove the limits of the sigma notation and we render it simply as shown on the bottom right hand corner of the screen. It is known from empirical grounds that the algebraic sum of residuals is actually zero. So we need to estimate the parameters so as to avoid this zero sum of residuals. We therefore adopt the least squares criterion, commonly called the sum of squared residuals or the sum of squared errors. This is denoted on the screen as sigma ui squared equals the sum of squared difference between yi minus yi hat. Opening the term yi hat, we have sigma ui squared equals sigma yi minus beta 1 hat minus beta 2 hat xi squared. Now, we can estimate the parameters beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat by minimizing the sum of squared residuals with respect to these estimates. Thus, the sum of squared residuals become a function of beta 1 hat and beta 2 hat. This is where we apply a method of differential calculus known as differentiation. We will therefore look at how to estimate these parameters in the next lesson. To this end, I hope you found this lesson useful. Thank you and have a nice day.